Hi everyone, it's great to be here. Thank you so much. I'm sure that when you saw Harp Revolution in the pit, your mind wandered off to all crazy fantasies. But it's just me, sorry. I'm not sure how a Harp Revolution would actually look like with all harpists coming to fight, so I don't know. And I'm not sure if I can live up to a revolution, but in all honesty, my last year has been sort of a revolution for myself. I'm a classically trained harpist. I've been playing the harp for over 20 years. And last year I decided to change everything, to stop my traveling life as a classical musician playing other people's work, and started to venture my own path as a music maker and as someone who plays his own music and plays with effects and strange new sort of things. Anyway, and today is a sort of result of all that, and I'm very happy to share that with you across the canal here in the UK. Thanks so much for being here, and the next song is called Leviathan. Thank you. Thanks a lot. This harp was invented by a Dutch guy living in London. So I'm sort of bringing the instrument back home. He's a friend of mine, and one day he just wrote me a message on Facebook. He had read an interview that I gave somewhere, and he said, "I think I'm designing the instrument of your dreams." So here it is. It's a complicated dream sometimes, but definitely I love it. And it was sort of a great accident in the good sense, because I was writing a piece. I was actually feeling very happy because I had written a piece while I was in a plane. And then I thought, oh, this would be great. Then I'll play it for an audience, and then I can say, oh, the next piece I wrote during a flight. And then it would be a great response from the audience. Anyway, that's what I thought. And then this piece was finished, and then it turned out to be a piece for like 5 harp players, 9 harps, and 13 hands. And I was sort of lost. I didn't know what to do. And fortunately, he came up with this instrument, and he brought along a loop pedal. And that sort of opened a completely new world for me and resulted in me being able to play the next song live. It's called Ariel, since it's about a sort of view that you get when you are in a plane looking actually over the Alps. Enjoy. Thank you. I was here in London. I had a performance at the St. John Smith Square, I believe, a big church. So back in my previous life, sort of. And I was in a cab, as you are, and I had looked on my phone. It was a drive of about 10 minutes to the hotel. But hey, London. So it took us 2 hours to get to the hotel. And, well, this gave us the opportunity to talk, to get to know each other. And this guy, his name is Ahmed, and he's from Afghanistan. And obviously, there's a lot going on in the world. And we started chatting about his life. And he told me he had come to the UK 10 years before. And he told me his story, that he fled the country and he was living here with his two kids and his wife. And what struck me was that he was so thankful and so hopeful about this new opportunity he got to build a new life here, to build something up from scratch. And he was driving, well, some harpist at 12 in the evening around London, and still there was a huge smile on his face after all he had endured. And it was sort of at that moment that for the first time actually that it struck me what it must mean to be in that position, to from one day to another have to leave your country. I imagined having to leave the Netherlands, having to stop to play the harp, and have to go to Afghanistan to become a doctor or something, which would be very bad news for people in Afghanistan, I'm sure. Anyway, he had given up that life as a doctor and was now there, that cab driver. And his story inspired me for the rest of the evening, and actually it was at that moment that I sort of wrote my first piece or idea. And it's dedicated to him. He doesn't know I wrote it, I'm sure. We never met again. And it's not that it would help him one bit that if he'd heard the song, but it's I do believe that music is about hope. And music is the thing that brings us together. And that I believe that in music lies a very important message that I wish for the world, and that's that in music there are no boundaries. And that's what this piece is about, and it's called Refugee. Thanks so much. You've been so wonderful. I've reached the last song of my set. I'll be back tomorrow if you feel like hearing more Harp Revolution stuff. Seriously, the title. Interesting. Anyway, it's great that you're all here. I really enjoyed it. And well, you know, I'm writing my own music now and performing with my band usually, so it feels a little naked in my own, being back on my own, but it also, it's sort of the essence, it's, I mean, I'm used to this instrument. Well, not this particular instrument, but anyway. I talk too much, that too. I'm probably way over my time. Anyway, my last song, and, well, you know, with a band, you know, you get, well, now I'm playing with a band, you suddenly have all those images that at some point you will, you know, play in a stadium, of course, with a, well, like rock bands do, right? So anyway, I'm waiting for that moment. And what I always love when I go to see a big show of a pop artist is that people know all their songs. And they all have hits, of course. The good news is that I have a hit as well. Yes. The bad news is that you probably have never heard it. So I'm not sure if that really counts for a hit. Anyway, I'm going to play it to you. It's called Frank. And I mean, it would be great if like what always happens when they start playing the hit and then people recognize and they start to sing along. And well, I can't expect you to do that, but like give at least a, if you would completely spontaneously have like a large cheer when you hear the theme of the song, would be that'd be amazing to sort of recreate that experience. Anyway, so it starts out with yeah, just the harp, but like that's every piece. And at some point I start to play the melody. And then that will be your cue. So thanks for cooperating. It's been great and I hope to see you again. Thanks.